여름방 인천광역시 교육청 중등생들부 여름방학 호주 프로야 중등생들부
Hi everyone! Welcome to another episode of Fun with Idioms. I'm teacher 은주장.
And I'm Ricardo. Welcome back. So this episode is about idioms related to feelings. Are you ready to learn some idioms, 은주?
Absolutely.
Let's go. So the first idiom in this episode that we're going to learn about is to be on cloud nine. Let's say this one more time. To be on cloud nine.
네, 이 표현은 아주아주 즐겁고 행복하다는 표현이에요. 클라우드는 구름이란 뜻인데 생각해보세요. 내가 구름 위에 올라가 있다면 얼마나 즐겁고 행복하겠어요. 그쵸? 그런데 리카르도 선생님, 왜 클라우드 뒤에 나인이 붙는 거예요?
So the reason why we say to be on cloud nine is because a long time ago, in the US weather system, they made a cloud level 9 as the highest and fluffiest cloud. So when you feel on like you're on cloud 9, you feel great or your feeling is really high. So cloud 9, level cloud 9 is the highest and fluffiest cloud.
네, 재밌네요. 그렇다면 만약에 친구가 나 구름 9에 있어 라는 의미의 I'm on cloud 9 이라고 말한다면 이 친구는 지금 아주 행복하고 들떠있는 상태겠어요. 왜냐면 가장 솜털 같은 구름의 꼭대기에 있는 거니까요. 마찬가지로 한번 그림을 보세요. 이 그림 속에서 이 아이는 너무 귀여운 고양이를 끌어안고 있죠. 이럴 때 말할 수 있을 것 같아요. I'm on cloud 9 now.
So exactly. So as you see in the picture, this person holding the cat looks very, very, very happy. Here's another example. So imagine this man here, he went on a blind date and he had a fantastic date. He would say to himself, oh, I feel like I'm on cloud nine because he had such a great time and a great experience. So he felt very happy. 은주 teacher, when was the last time, do you remember any time that you felt you were on cloud nine?
저는 개인적으로 수능을 끝나고 제가 처음으로 운전면허를 땄을 때 아주 기분이 좋았어요. At that time, I felt like I was on cloud 9 because I could go anywhere like most adults do.
Okay, yeah, I can imagine. The freedom must have been fantastic. Now let's watch a clip of a real life situation using the idiom to be on cloud 9.
I'm on cloud 9.
So moving on, the next expression that we're going to learn about is to feel blue. Let's say this one more time. To feel blue.
네, 이거는 슬프거나 우울하다는 뜻이에요. 그래서 만약에 누군가가 I'm feeling blue now 라고 한다면 그 사람은 지금 슬프거나 기분이 좋지 않은 상태를 의미하는 거예요.
Exactly. So if you look at the picture below, you can see that this girl has broken up with her boyfriend. So she looks really sad. So we can say she is blue because she broke up with her boyfriend.
좋은 예시예요, 리카르도 선생님. 근데 선생님, when do you feel blue?
Oh, me? When do I feel blue?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. I normally don't feel blue, but whenever there's rainy weather, my feeling is a little sad or a little depressed, maybe because I like good weather. So the weather affects my emotions a lot.
사실은 저도 그래요. 비가 오면 괜히 기분이 처지고 푹 가라앉는 느낌이 들거든요.
I think it is for most people.
Yeah,
Yeah.
maybe.
So let's now watch a real life situation using the expression to feel blue.
Oh, hello, Sam. How are you?
I was feeling blue today.
Blue? You're not blue. Humans are not blue.
Hanzo, what did you do to him? He's already feeling blue. He just broke up with his girlfriend.
What? He broke up with his girlfriend? But why is he blue? He is not the color blue.
It means he's really sad.
Oh, I feel like an idiot. Now I feel blue because you're so sad. Let's go get some ice cream to cheer us up.
Sounds like a great idea for no blueberry ice cream.
Okay.
And the final idiom for today's episode is to walk on eggshells. Let's say it one more time, to walk on eggshells.
리카르도 선생님, 그런데 eggshells가 무슨 뜻이에요?
So an eggshell is the outer part of an egg. So you have an egg, right? And then you, for example, crack the egg. This part here is the egg shell. So as you can see below, those are egg shells. Now, imagine if you are walking on eggshells. You walk very, very cautiously and carefully, as if there are real eggshells on the ground.
맞아요. 만약에 제가 계란 위를 걸어야 한다면 아주 아주 조심해서 걸어야 할것 같은데요. 그래서 to walk on the eggshells라는 표현은 우리가 무언가를 말하거나 행동할 때 아주 아주 조심해서 행동해야 한다라는 뜻이 되겠어요. 마치 한국어의 살얼음판을 걷다라는 표현과 비슷하게 느껴지는데 맞나요?
Exactly. So, but with this idiom, we must keep in mind that we only use it for interpersonal relationships. So, this is an expression that you use when you really do not want to upset someone.
그렇군요. 우리말에 살얼음판을 걷다는 여러 가지 상황에서 쓸수 있는 말이지만, 이 영어 표현 to walk on eggshells는 어떤 사람과의 관계 속에서 쓸수 있는 말이에요. 그림을 보세요. 우리 그림 속에 쥐들이 고양이 목에 방울을 달도록 노력하고 있는데요. 지금 고양이는 자고 있잖아요. 그래서 이 고양이를 깨우게 될까봐 살얼음판을 걷고 있는 모습이에요. 이럴 때 우리가 말할 수 있겠죠. These mice are walking on eggshells.
So, yeah, they are walking on eggshells, and the reason why, it's because they're being very careful not to wake up the cat. So they're kind of walking on eggshells.
Ricardo teacher, have you had any experience when you had to walk on eggshells?
Oh, yes, of course, I've had many times, but one time I remember was when I was in middle school. I got bad grades on my report card, and I had to tell my parents. So I was walking on eggshells in telling them. So I waited until my mother and father were in a good mood, and I told them my bad news because I was very careful, but they still got angry at me. So my plan on walking on eggshells did not work. How about you, Inju?
저도 당연히 살얼음판을 걸었던 때가 있는데요. 사실은 예전에 제 여동생이 아주 예쁜 드레스를 산 거예요. 원피스 샀는데, 제가 그걸 몰래 입고 나갔는데, 모르고 김칫국물을 흘려버린 거예요. 근데 이거를 동생에게 얘기를 해야 되는데, 그때 I was walking on eggshells.
Oh my goodness, what an embarrassing situation.
Right.
So now let's take a look at walking on eggshells in a real life situation.
Oh, Ricardo, this clip looks familiar. Where is it from?
You don't know? It was from the news last year. It was so famous. Hey, Eunju, look!
Oh, the cat is now walking on eggshells. Why?
Well, I guess this cat just made his friends upset. He ate up his friend's lunch without permission.
Oh, I see. This cat must be walking on eggshells in a relationship with his friends.
Exactly.
His girlfriend, but why is he?